Welcome to Mastering Solutions. In this projectile motion problem, they tell us that on the Apollo 14 mission to the moon, the astronaut Alan Shepard hit a golf ball with a golf club, and the free fall acceleration on the moon is 1/6 the value that it is on the Earth. And so they give us this value, 25 meters per second at an angle of 30 degrees above the horizontal, and then want us to find these answers here. So what we have is, we'll say this is the velocity vector to represent the 25 meters per second. Here's the x component of that. So we'll say vix. Here's the y component of that. So viy. And it was hit at an angle of 30 degrees above the horizontal. So for part A, we have to figure out how long it was in the air, how far did it travel for part B, and then how much farther would it go on the moon than on the Earth for part C. For part A, we're trying to figure out the time. How long was it in the air for? And just like any question with kinematics, there are several ways that we can approach this. So if you do one that's slightly different than I do, but you get the same answer, it just is going to show you that the math is the same with kinematics. The equation that I'll be using is just the expanded form of the acceleration equation. So to show you what I'm talking about, acceleration is equal to the change in velocity over the change in time. We'll break up the delta v, so v final minus v initial divided by delta t, and then we'll isolate t by multiplying both sides, t. So now we have acceleration times time is equal to v final minus v initial. In order for this to work, what we're looking at is only half of the ball in the air. So if we imagine the ball gets hit and then it comes up right here where it stops for a second in the y direction, the y component of the velocity will be zero, and then it's going to come back down. So we're only looking at the first half of this right here. So the v final is zero. So now we want to isolate time by dividing both sides by acceleration. So the negative initial velocity divided by acceleration is equal to time. We're looking at only the y component here. So when we plug in our values, the negative initial velocity is the initial velocity in the y direction. It's on the opposite of the angle, and we have the hypotenuse, so we'll use sine. So that'll be sine of theta is equal to opposite over hypotenuse. We'll isolate the opposite by multiplying both sides of the equation by h. So the opposite is equal to h sine theta. So now this value right here is equal to the initial velocity in the y direction. So we'll plug that in for right here. So we have negative, the v initial y is h sine theta, which we said is 25 hypotenuse meters per second, times the sine of the angle theta, which in this case is 30 degrees for the angle. When we divide it by the acceleration, obviously acceleration is going to be negative g, but we're on the moon, not on Earth, so it's going to be negative 9.8 meters per second squared, and they say that gravity on the moon is 1/6 of what it is on the Earth, so we'll divide this by 6. So the time that it will be in flight for is negative 25 times the sine of the angle 30 divided by negative 9.8 meters per second squared divided by 6. So for the first half is 7.65 seconds, but we want it for the whole time that it's in the air for. So we need to multiply this by 2 because we're only looking at the first half of the flight time with this equation right here. So it's going to be 15.3. You could round that to 3.1. I'm going to keep it at 3. So the answer for part A is 15.3 seconds. In part B, they ask, how far did it travel? And so we need to figure out the x distance for the golf ball. We're going to use the velocity equation, which is velocity is the change in the distance over the change in time. We want to figure out this right here. So let's multiply both sides by t. So we have delta x is equal to velocity times time. We could break this up if we wanted to have final minus initial and solve for the x final, but it will be the exact same value because our x initial is zero. So the delta x and the x final will be the same. Now this velocity, we need to specify a little bit better so we don't get confused. So delta x is equal to the initial velocity in the x direction times the time. because that is not going to be 25. It's going to be the adjacent of the angle, which is cosine. So just like we did up above, we'll have cosine of theta is equal to adjacent over hypotenuse. We'll multiply both sides by h. So adjacent is equal to h cosine of theta. H in this case is 25, and the angle, of course, is 30. So when we plug in our numbers here, we'll have 25 meters per second times cosine of the angle 30 degrees. Now we'll multiply that, which is our initial velocity in the x direction, times the time which we found of 15.3 seconds. So we have 25 cosine 30 times the time of 15.3 gives us a total distance in the x direction that it went of 331. So we have 331.3 meters. Look at your question to see how many significant figures they want you to round to. So this is the answer for part B, 331 meters, or you could put the 0.3 or 0.25. With most of the questions in mastering physics, in my experience in the past, it would allow you to put in the full answer and then it would round for you and say, hey, you had a rounding error but wouldn't take any points off. But I think your professors can set that differently. So to be safe, put in however many significant figures your question asks for. For the last part, C, they ask us how much further would it go on the moon than it would on the Earth. We already figured out how far it would go on the moon though, so now we just need to figure out how far would it go on the Earth and then subtract the two. In order to do this last part, part C, I'm going to do the exact same process that we did above. This is the delta x for Earth, only I'm going to combine the equations into one. So don't allow that to confuse you. It's literally the same. Just to save a little bit of time, I'm going to put it all together. Just like we did above, we need the initial velocity in the x direction times the time. This is all for Earth. The initial velocity in the x direction will be the exact same. So it's going to be 25 meters per second times the cosine of the angle 30. The only thing that's different is the gravity is different. So the initial velocity will be the same for the moon and for the Earth. When we times it by the time, it's going to be in the air longer though. And just like we did above, we had the y component of the initial velocity, which we said was negative 25 times the sine of 30. And then we divided that by the gravity, but in this case, it's only negative 9.8 meters per second squared because we're on Earth again. And then we had to multiply this by 2 to get the whole flight path. And this is a representation of what we did above for the time. So when we plug all that in, we get 25 times the cosine of 30 for the initial velocity in the x direction. And then we'll multiply that by negative 25 times the sine of 30, and then divided by negative 9.8 meters per second squared times 2 gives us the total distance for the Earth of 55.2 meters. 55.2 meters. So now to find the final answer for C, like I talked about already, we're going to take 331 and we're going to subtract 55.2. That's meters and meters. So we have 331 minus 55.2 gives us a total distance of 275.8, so 276. 276 meters is how much further it will go on the moon than it will on the Earth. And for significant figures, you could round that to two significant figures, which would be 280 meters. If it were me, I would probably put in the 276, but like we discussed above, put in whatever number of significant figures they ask for. This is three significant figures, and this is two.